A very good morning, students of class 8. Today we will discuss new lesson in history, chapter 8, expansion of British power in India. As we know, the Britishers had come in India as a trader, but later on they had interfered the India's rulers internal and external matter, and they had defeated also the another European East India companies, and they had formed British East India Company as a trading company. But later on they had defeated other European East India companies traders, and after that became a supreme power in India, and they had interfered the matters external and internal of the Rajas, and they became supreme power in India. After that they became a ruler of India. India became a colony of British. So let's go through the lesson for better understanding of this lesson. British made strategic policies. The English East India Company, which had started out as a trading company in 1600, had by 1773 become one of the major contenders for supreme power in India. To British also realize that the fighting wars with the different regional rulers to expand their power was not always feasible. Wars were usually expensive and added severe strain on the British resources. To avoid fighting wars, the British devised strategic policies that would help them eliminate all their rivals one by one and establish an all India empire. They fought wars only when the peaceful ways of annexing a territory failed. Thus, the British policy was expanding powers in India was based on a two-pronged strategy of, first, peaceful annexation, and second, military conquest. The British also annexed some territories under the pretext of maladministration or misgovernment. In that we see the first point, the subsidiary alliance. The subsidiary alliance system was a method perfected by Lord Wellesley, the Governor General of India, from 1797 until 1805 to subjugate Indian powers without the cost of and bother of war. Means without war they had applied the subsidiary alliance, and through that they had expanded their kingdom. Any Indian ruler whose security was threatened was encouraged to seek help from and enter into an alliance with the British, who promised to protect the ruler from external attacks and internal revolts. The Indian ruler had to accept certain terms and conditions. This arrangement was known as subsidiary alliance. The conditions were as follows. Means subsidiary alliance they had applied, and the Rajas also accepted, because they were giving that external and internal the protection to the kingdom, and external attacks by the any other aggressive rajas to them, they were defeating, they were protecting to the kingdom, and internal revolts were taking place, that one they were controlling. The first subsidiary alliance conditions were the British troops for the protection of the Indian ruler would be permanently placed in the territory of the subsidiary state. Second, the Indian ruler would have to pay for the maintenance of the troops. Payment would be made in cash or in kind, that is, by ceding part of his territory. Since Indian ruler had to pay the maintenance of the British troops, they were giving a salaries, paying that wages in cash or in kind. He had to keep the British official, means resident, in his courts. He would not employ any European except the British in his service or dismiss those who were already there. Means according to the term and condition, the British official must be keep in his court, so that the person can the observe of any kind of all kind of the activities of the rajas. And then the Raja could not employ any European except British, means other European, like we can say German, French, or Portuguese, or the Spanish, any that European cannot be give in the service. If already they are appointed in their court, then they have to dismiss, remove from their that post. Another, you can see, he could not form an alliance with any other power or declare war against any power without the permission of the British. He would acknowledge the British company as a paramount power. Means the Raja or the ruler cannot make any kind of alliance with any other rulers or the any Europeans. Means if they wanted to do of that, means have to take a permission. Unko permission lena padta tha British East India Company se. Agar wo permission dene ke baad hi wo kini dusre rajaon ke saath ya koi dusre European ko apna court mein appoint kar sakte the ya kisi bhi prakar ka alliance kar sakte the. We can see here now that effect of the subsidiary alliance. In subsidiary alliance, they were not removing to the ruler, they were appointing to the ruler, but the ruler, the king, must pay the annual tribute and whatever the conditions and terms that he had to complete. The subsidiary alliance proved very advantageous for the British. The British maintained large armies at the expense of the Indian rulers. The British acquired valuable territories as subsidiary amount payment. This led to the expansion of the British Empire in India and an increase in its resources. Third, we have to see the influence of European rivals, especially the French, was excluded from the courts of the Indian rulers. Means the Europeans, French officials were appointed in the Raja's court, the Indian ruler's court. They had been completely removed from the court of the Rajas, and they were used to keep only the British officials. The British controlled the foreign policy of the subsidiary states. Here we see some of the disadvantages of the Indian rulers. The subsidiary alliance had disastrous effects on the Indian states. First, the Indian ruler of subsidiary state lost their independence. they virtually became puppets in the hands of the British. Means all the power, जितना भी राजा के पास अपना power होता था, सभी powers को British अपने handle में रख लिए, उनके control में चला गया, जिससे राजा को rule तो करता था, राजा तो था, but mostly उनके पास power नहीं हुआ करते थे, और जिसके कारण से बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं उनके puppets इन हैंड में चला गया, उनके लोग पपेट हो गए, चापलूस बाज लोग हैं उसके हाथ में, कुछ ग्रीड रूलर्स और ऑफिसर्स लोग राजाओं के हाथ में चले गए. द पेमेंट ऑफ ह्यूज सब्सिडीज लेड टू द हेवी ड्रेन ऑन देयर दैट रिसोर्सेस एंड द इम्पोवरिशमेंट एंड डीके ऑफ द स्टेट्स द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन कोलैप्स्ड. When the administration collapsed, the British used it as an excuse for annexing the kingdom on grounds of misgovernment. Next point, the Indian rulers were fully protected by the British against external and internal enemies. They lost in interest in the welfare of the people and neglected them as they were no longer afraid of revolts. The people suffered untold miseries under irresponsible and oppressive rulers. The subsidiary alliance aided the British in subjugating the powerful kingdom of the Marathas. Here we see that another point, subjugations of the Marathas. The third battle of Panipat 1761 was a major turning point in the history of India. The defeat of the combined forces of the Mughals and the Marathas at the hands of the Afghan ruler Ahmad Shah Abdali proved disastrous for the country. He left India drained and fragmented. Means by seeing of these, the several time the Afghan ruler Ahmad Shah Abdali attacked on India and he had looted the property and the wealth of India. The Rajas were also had fought with them, they had wasted a lot of money. The Maratha Empire broke up into five virtual independent states. The powers of the Peshwa, the former head of the Maratha Empire, had declined. The four other centers of the Maratha power were the Gayakwad family of Baroda in Gujarat and the Vonsle family of Nagpur in Berar and the Sindhias of Gwalior and the Holkers of Indore. Maharashtra was the under the Peshwa who was based in Pune. Means later on the Marathas power had been completely broke and empire divided into three virtual independent states. First became the Gayakwad family of the Baroda in Gujarat, second became Vonsle family of the Nagpur in Berar, and then Sindhias of the Gwalior and the Holkers of Indore, and the Maharashtra means Peshwa's headquarters became Pune. The Marathas, who controlled most of the western and central India, made a remarkable recovery after the third battle of Panipat. Despite being a house divided, the Marathas proved to be formidable rivals. It took the British 43 years, 1775 to 1818, and three wars to bring the Marathas under their control. Gradually, later on, that Maratha power also had came under the British, because they have fought, they had divided, the one power was Maratha power that had been completely divided into the several five kingdoms, and they had faced a lot of problem with the British. So they had also later on gradually surrendered to the British and became a puppet ruler means they accepted subsidiary alliance and all the power went to British and British became the master of the Marathas. So students, next class will study and discuss about the first Anglo-Maratha war in 1775 and to 1782. So kindly go through your lesson and study it so that you can able to understand. Thank you so much.